talking about where you come from, Chaitanya, in terms of you're a full-on Bombay boy. Would that be correct to say?
Yeah, right?
And it's the city. It's the city you've grown up in. It's the city that you've captured twice on screen. I think the Bombay I saw in The Disciple is very different from the Bombay I've seen in most films. And it seemed like a conscious choice you made as well. I mean, this is a quieter Bombay. The roads don't have as many people. And especially that the scene that you know, that motif that you use of the protagonist on the bike and the music that sort of goes with the pace of the bike's movement. And there's quietness and there's a mental soliloquy. I mean, was that again a conscious thing that you had in mind when you set out? And what was the reason behind it?
Yeah, because, you know, there are a few different things that work on a story level, a narrative level. It's set in a period, right? The film starts off in 2006.
Right.
And it's a very different Bombay from a Bombay of 2021.
Right.
Okay. Also, it's a city which Sharad has been born and raised in, and it's a city that's full of possibilities for him at that point. And the night becomes this haven, this cocoon, where he doesn't have to confront reality, doesn't have to confront real life and practical challenges and logistical obstacles that stand in his way. And also, I must tell you that, you know, that is Mumbai still.
Right.
If you go for a drive, I mean, not now, but one of my favorite things to do before the lockdown was to go for long drives at 3 or 4 in the morning with a friend of mine, because I don't drive. This is Mumbai still, you know. But of course, we've done some little sorcery, and we've chosen locations carefully also to depict the period. But if you see, the city starts getting noisier, the city starts getting more modern and starts getting more dynamic and starts closing in on the character as his journey progresses. You know, because it's a great city, it's one of the great cities of the world, but it's not an easy city to navigate, you know.
Right. Do you bike around though, Chaitanya?
No, I don't bike. I don't drive a car. I'm a total babe.
No, the reason I'm asking is the whole idea of him having a conversation with himself while he's alone in the bike is also pretty close to reality. A lot of people, you know, a lot of bikers do that when they're by themselves. They can only hear the sound of the machine and their own head.
Yeah.
That's also something that you've taken from reality. Would that be correct to say?
Yeah. I mean, I just had to find a motive, you know, or a way to express it. Like, for example, I walk a lot. I used to walk a lot on the beach before this lockdown happened. Or even when me and my friend would go for this drive in the car, we would quite often be very quiet and be in our own thoughts. And or like some old Hindi song is playing in the background, but it puts you in a different mode, you know, without all the noise, which we are so desensitized to. And so used to. I don't know if you're in Mumbai still, but
I am.
We have become desensitized to the amount of noise and sound. Right. And also, I'm a night person personally. From my television days, I acquired this habit of working at night because I was forced to back then. But yeah, it's just so quiet, you know, and just you don't have any of the disturbances. So
right. I mean, that's obviously a technique that you use to get into the character's mind. The other technique that you use is the voiceover of the great person whose recordings exist. I mean, she passed away recently. I mean, is there any particular reason why you chose to approach Sumitra Bhave of all the people for that particular voicing, as it were?
I came across an interview of hers and I heard her voice. And this was when I had an idea. I mean, my description in the script was, this is the voice of God, you know. It has to have that kind of a power and aura to it. And when I heard her voice, I was like, this voice is just so cinematic, you know. It's nothing like the conventional voice that we are used to hearing in voiceovers. It's so textured, so unique, and it was also the kind of perfect embodiment of the authoritative, you know, discourses that I had read or heard from musicians.
Right.
You know, and I was like, it would be great if she does this. And she was kind enough to agree, even though she had never done anything like this before. She told me that she'd never acted before. And she was nervous like an actor, you know, while doing it. But she was fantastic. And I remember even after we had done the recording, way before we started shooting, because Aditya Modak, the actor, actually kept listening to those tapes for months and months before we started shooting to psych himself out. But even then, I remember just, you know, making everyone hear it. I'm like, listen to this. Isn't this amazing? And then we, of course, worked on it quite a lot on the sound design level, on the mix level, and created a whole arc and a whole journey where her voice and her character starts getting more and more oppressive and almost tyrannical, you know,
right,
for Sharad.
Subscribe to Midday India. Get direct notifications on all our videos by clicking on the bell icon.